Here we are at 401 games on a Wednesday night. Watching a prototype Toronto League top 8 match between Billy Chandler. He'll be on the left with the Strikers, and he's wearing a wine-colored shirt. And Jeff Assiri on the right, and I'm here with Emily Parker.
Hey.
And I'm Aaron Peake. And during the league season, league members play 7 matches in 7 weeks. During that time, they cannot repeat a list or a named pilot. And so this is a top 8 match following after the regular season. And they've saved these particular pilots for both these matches. Both these guys were in the top 8 last season. And so they've sat on these particular pilots, reserving them for last.
They're really fighting for that top 4 spot.
They are. These are bloodthirsty fellas. So on the left-hand side, what do we have over there with Billy?
So looks like Billy has the regular outfitted Omega Leader with the Countess Ryad, Push the Limit, Twin Ion, Tie X7. Important to note, in this game, the nerfs will not be in effect, so he can still bump and get that free evade token if he wants. And then he's got 2 of the Imperial trainees with lightweight frames and adaptive ailerons. Now, I'm not familiar with any of those because I've been out of the game for a little while. You want to tell me what those do?
Sure, they're really fun. So, with the title, before they do their maneuver, which has been programmed, they have to do a little white maneuver, either a one straight or a one bank. They must do that before they activate their maneuver. Now that's a maneuver itself, it's not an action. And if they bump during the aileron maneuver, but not during their main maneuver, they still get an action. The lightweight frame allows them to add a green die if they have less green dice than the person shooting at them has red dice. So in this case, if they're being shot at by 3 red dice, they also go up to 3.
Right.
Doesn't stack with range. Rocks. It does stack with range or rocks, but it won't go higher than the 3 red dice, than the number of attack dice that the opponent has.
Right.
So it won't matter. Can't go higher than 3 in this matchup. And on the right, we have Jeff's list. He's got Colonel Vessery with the Tie D title. So he's busting out the Tie D. And he's got a tractor beam to go with that. Veteran Instincts to put Vess at 8. And Twin Ion Engine, just in case he got thrown any stress, which won't happen here. Billy is already on the move. He's got his Tie Strikers sweeping in from the bottom of the screen. We have Omega Leader with Juke, Comm Relay, and Stealth Device for Jeff, and Backdraft with Adaptability, Fire Control System, Pattern Analyzer, so he can still take an action even if he does a red maneuver, Lightweight Frame himself, and the Spec Ops Training Title, which allows him to shoot 3 red dice from the front, or fire twice, 2 from the front and 2 from the rear. And Backdraft always adds a crit result to shots taken out his back arc. So we have most of Billy's list moving first. Riot is down to 1 bank. We'll only get 1 action, which Billy doesn't even care about. I'm so confident in see that nothing's going to get on him this round. And he's a mega leader. So Billy has the initiative here. Jeff is 8s across the board. So, pilot skill advantage will be huge here. Now, I've seen Billy play these guys before, these trainees, and he loves to use them to swoop in and attack at range 1 or go for blocks.
I mean, right now, it looks like we're set up to just go for one big head-on fight.
From what I've seen from Jeff, that is his way.
All right.
Unless he's got that nice tractor beam to really punk one of those ships with, which tells us why Billy's coming up the side like that, to avoid being slapped on those rocks by that tractor beam.
I like that we can see some of the dials, so we can see their thought process here. Maybe this, maybe not.
Yeah. He's really giving it a think here. Well, it really does look like Jeff's set up just to charge in and start blasting.
Yeah. I mean, Billy's got the numbers for Jeff's. But Jeff has the PS advantage, so.
Indeed. So with the ailerons maneuver, those strikers have a can go up to speed 5. So the fastest maneuver is 3. So 2 plus the ship length. Sorry, a 1 plus the ship length, and then a 3 gives them about a 5. A little bit faster if it's all banks. But that's not enough to get him into blocking range, I think, if Jeff does short maneuvers.
Mm-hmm.
Ones for them to can and twos for the other guys. He's got a real problem moving second with his Omega Leader. Oh, sorry, moving first. Billy has a real problem moving first with his Omega Leader. He won't be able to get a lock in the first round. So if you're Jeff, who do you get rid of first?
I think for me it would depend on who else is shooting back at me, because if everybody on Billy's side is going to have a shot, I would take out one of the strikers just before they even get to shoot.
Mm-hmm.
But that might not always be the best idea, I'm not sure.
Seems pretty solid. I mean, the temptation is, because a Mega Leader will be coming in without a lock, to go for a Mega Leader. And if he ends up next to that asteroid.
But even with the lock, he still has 2 other ships to shoot at him with.
Mm-hmm. No lock for Riot. Considering a barrel roll. Nope, he's just going to stick. Bank 3 from the Mega Leader? Just a bank 2. Oh, he's very close to that asteroid. Maybe what we should do here is barrel roll to his left. Oh, he's just going to focus. I'm really afraid a Mega Leader's going to hit that tractor beam here.
Yeah, right onto the rock. It would be good for Jeff.
Focus for backdraft. Okay, so assuming one of Billy's ships is going to get wrecked here.
Yeah.
Who do his remaining 3 target?
I'm just trying to figure out the range. They haven't put down a ruler yet, so I can't quite get an idea of how far everything is. Oh, here we go.
I think it's 2s across the board, and that's just in range, I think. Oh, maybe not.
That looks just out. Yeah, he fits it in there.
Oh.
All right, that's exactly what I need to see.
So he's just going to target lock one of the strikers. And is Vessery doing a 2 or a 3? He's doing a 3. Maybe he'll have range on...
Vessery looks like he might be out of range for everything.
Well, this is nice range management for Billy when he was vulnerable.
Yeah, for sure.
Also, looks like Vess can't do that 4K next round. Oh, but he's not a tied X7, so he doesn't care.
Less seen tidy.
So his Omega Leader gets to shoot at backdraft. Okay. 2 hits. Lucky dice. And 2 evades. Oh, but he's not locked. It's not locked, Jeff. There's no target lock. You don't have to do that.
I think he was just trying to decide if he wanted it for offense or defense.
Juke.
Yeah. Oh, does he have range?
Looks like he does.
Looks like he'll be able to focus his fire then.
Acquire the lock with Vessery. Spend it immediately. And will he tractor beam or no? No, he's just going to leave it at 2. And Billy will spend his focus to evade the tractor beam shot. Right call for sure. And he focuses for 3. And the trainee only gets 1. 2 damage on trainee number 3. Comes a megaliter shot, 2 hits. This is most likely it for trainee number 3.
Oh, blanked it out.
Blanked it out. He's a gunner.
That was quick.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's unfortunate. It allows Backdraft to start doing some work on somebody. Shoot at a megaliter. Oh, no.
The Omega Leader without the lock is a good shot here.
I'd be tempted to do that as well. Just 1 hit, and it's evaded. See if he remembers his fire control system. He does.
You're gonna do this to me anyway, you know it.
That's the true test of skill. Can you remember your FCS or not?
Oh yeah, Billy's got shots. So it looks like Riad has range 3 through a rock on Vessery. Maybe he'll get a damage through. Oh wow.
That's 3 hits.
They determine it's not cocked. Vessery rolls big 4-5 dice and takes 1. As predicted. And Striker takes a shot at S. Nope.
Didn't quite have range.
Doesn't want to bother shooting a mega leader, so he'll probably shoot Backdraft. And it's 2 hits. Backdraft blanks. Loses all his shields. Oh no, 1 shield remains. So Billy lost a ship, but
that's kind of what we thought would happen.
Yeah, I mean, it wasn't the worst ship to lose.
Was Billy able to do enough damage to make up for it, though, in this round? So, who do you think the primary...
Wasn't even looking. Sorry, Am, what?
Oh, who do you think the primary target on each side is right now? Because I honestly don't know what I'd be going after.
I think I'd try to get rid of Backdraft if I was
Backdraft, yeah.
He's hurt the most, and he's the easiest to kill.
Yeah, how many green dice does Backdraft have?
He's got 2, but then that goes up to 3 versus Riad or the Striker, because they've got
right,
3 attacks,
yes.
3 reds
okay.
Themselves. I think it's a positional question here. I mean, I think we'll see a bank 1 from Vessery just so he can keep arc.
Yeah.
And if I were Jeff, I'd just try to kill another ship.
Whatever's prime target, depending on where they go.
Not right.
He's kind of in a good position to take whatever gives him a juicy shot.
Yeah. Billy has to be thinking about how many ships he has to block with here, and how many he has to use to shoot, and where he can position them to do that. And Riad has the luxury of moving before all those aces. She can 3 straight, target lock, and token. And hope to be able to blast somebody in the face. But a megaliter's not... Billy's megaliter is not in such a great spot. He might well have all 3 guns on him.
Yeah,
So he's doing an aileron away, and then probably a hard one or a hard two here to try to flank. It's a really nice maneuver you can do with these guys. Oh, he goes for a sloop. Just getting the heck out of there.
Hopefully avoiding all arcs.
A daring move.
Saw how fast the other one went down.
Yeah. And we've got, looks like 5K from Ryan.
May pull a couple of blocks with that one.
He's got to be open. You want a barrel roll or lock? He's got a lock. Wow. And attempt to keep Megaliter out of arcs. Thing is, Backdraft can just plant a three straight and then shoot someone out his butt.
Right, yeah, yeah.
Which is terrifying. I mean, it's like three red dice at range one plus one crit. And he's got a target lock on the Megaliter already. Ah, but Omega Leader target locked Backdraft.
Probably a good idea.
This is what he does. It's a three bank.
Looks like he clears it too.
Yep, he's gonna fit in there right in front of Ryan. Nicely called by Billy. Well, presumably he's hoping for the block.
Yeah, because he took the lock on Bessery.
Just shaking his head and for some reason not taking his action. I think he's forgotten his action. There's the bank one from Bess. Token confusion happening.
It's getting a little messy in there. Everyone's just flying right in. Oh, here's the bump. But he's going to bump into his own ship.
Yep.
A nice shot on Countess.
So that went pretty well for Billy. I mean, a lot depends on whether or not Vessery, how hard Vessery's going to hammer Riot. But there's no lock on Riot yet, so Vessery's just taking TB shot and then his regular shot with a focus. Just one focus for both of those shots. I'm not quite sure who's rolling defense. I suppose we'll see with token expenditure. So,
I think that was Omega Leader onto Ryan.
Or I think that was Backdraft, maybe? No, 404. Two shields off Ryan. Oh, that was a tractor beam shot, and then the primary shot from Vessery.
Okay.
So that was great for Jeff. Two shields off Riot and her token stripped. Mega Leader on Riot. Jukes one. She takes another one. She is shieldless. And now Backdraft. So. Whoa. Three hits and a crit. And she is dead. No, she's not dead. Yes, she's dead.
That was quick.
It was. I'm not sure where the lock came from on professor used to re-roll dice on Raya.
There was another lock beside her. I don't know whose it was.
Oh, maybe Backdraft did take a lock on her when he moved into position. It looks like Billy just blanked with the striker.
Oh, ouch.
So Jeff destroyed his most powerful ship and Billy got not even a shot.
Yeah.
That's a crushing round.
Yeah, Riot was in the perfect spot to just get pounded by everybody.
Mm-hmm. So the striker now can't do an ailerons maneuver because it's stressed. Doesn't look like Billy's Omega Leader can sloop. Maybe he could sloop to the left. Tough to say. Backdraft's gonna have to get turned around.
I think we're gonna see a bit of repositioning on both sides here.
Mm-hmm. Vestrio probably just one bank to the left, try shooting that striker in the face.
It's proven an effective strategy so far.
It's pretty good. It's what the tidy does. So both of these guys joined the league, I think, just last season, and both of them made the top eight in their first season, I believe.
They're both really, really good players, although they would both tell you that they've never beat me.
Aha!
I've only played each of them maybe two or three times, but neither of them have beat me before.
Nice. Well, you're a champ too, as the trophies on your wall attest.
Yeah, I think they're both pretty much Imperial players through and through.
Yeah, sometimes Billy will play something else, but Jeff is almost always a Imperial jousting list. Actually, I played him last season in the top eight, and he flew Ray and Corrin against me.
Oh, really? Yeah. Mm-hmm. I played him for his first game in the league last season. I beat him, but he had a couple of defenders or something, and we just jousted it out.
I remember watching that. You had, like, Corrin and Aaron Kraken and...
Something else with the same PSA. I think it was Poe.
Nice.
Yeah.
What would you do with Omega Leader, were you Billy?
I don't even know. Like, he needs to get repositioned, but he's going to be vulnerable for...
I'm thinking a hard two northward is his best choice.
That's what I was thinking too, yeah.
And Backdraft does a one straight... Oh, Omega Leader still has Backdraft locked, so that's good. But if Omega Leader does a one straight, he can shoot from his powerful back arc again. Man, this is a very thinky planning phase. How much time? Oh, we're got action. So one straight. And that trainee is as yet undamaged.
See if he can lay down some hurt.
He's taking an evade, so he's hoping to survive. And we've got.
It's a good strategy.
One hard. From Billy's Omega Leader.
Yeah.
And he's He's going to barrel roll. Get right up in Vesta's grill and hopefully block him. Vesta's a kid, of course, he's in trouble. Billy may be making a mistake and seeing a defender and thinking about it in terms of an X7. Because it's really just obvious when you're flying a tie, you just do bank ones, pull back, and shoot with your big cannons. Although it doesn't look like a one bank would fit. I don't know. We'll have to see.
Yeah, I think a 4K would be better for him there.
Yep, one straight from backdraft. Target locks. Strike it. Oh, it's a bank too. Oh, nicely called, Billy. Oh, right. Backdraft took the target lock on the striker, so Vesery
can get one. Yeah. That makes sense.
So, in fact, the block, Billy's block didn't end up doing much good at all. Oh, well, looks like it's going to bump up Jeff's Omega Leader.
Traffic jam.
Woo-hoo.
Hard one? Yeah, he's not getting hardly anywhere.
Which means no lock for Jeff's Omega Leader. It's not bad. It's a salvage attempt. Go with Billy's Omega Leader. He's shooting somebody at range one. Must be the other Omega Leader. One crit. Oh, yeah. Jeff's Omega Leader's got stealth. Whoa!
He only rolled one evade, though.
And he has to spend his evade token because of juke.
Right.
Jeff's going to shoot the striker first. He spends the lock. Two hits and a crit. Requires the lock, right?
Yeah, SCS.
And so Billy spends an evade and takes only one crit. Hopes it isn't too bad. Looks like blinded pilot, especially given the way it was discarded. Yes, it is. That's horrible. That's just horrible. Oh. And Billy was already down and he gets that bad luck. And here comes Vesery's kill shot. Wires the lock, spends the lock, three hits. So tractor beam goes in. Looks like Jeff will decide not to roll him. Just apply the tractor beam token. And take a sweet range shot. So the striker's agility is now base one, plus one for the frames.
Right.
And spends the lock. And it's three.
Three hits.
One and two, nothing at all. So it takes all three and is extinguished.
Ouch.
Ouch indeed.
All right, so can Omega Leader pull this out? Omega Leader's great for the end game.
He is, but he's got a tidy defender that's got a K-turn behind him. Oh, it's bad.
This not looking good.
No.
For Billy, at least. For Jeff, it's looking great.
Yes. This is the point in the game where if you're the player who's down, you're like, okay, I have to kill a ship now. Just one ship.
We've only had, what, two rounds of shooting now? It's been a ship around. Or three rounds.
Is it only two rounds of shooting?
Wow. No, three. Because the first round we lost the first striker. Second round we lost Countess.
You're right.
Round we just lost
it's
another...
It's three rounds of the ship around. Wow, devastating.
I mean, that's the dream.
It is, yeah. Yeah, the unfortunate thing about a megaliter is he just doesn't have much punch.
Yeah.
If you don't get naturally good dice, which you should probably not ever count on, doing a hard two, he's trying to stick on.
Got his lock on Backdraft.
Yeah, so he'll take a focus token and, I don't know.
Try and chip away.
But Vessery's going to be behind him. Just a megaliter. Decides he's not even needed, so just exits the fight. Yeah, you guys got this, I'm going home. He does grab a target lock with Vessery en route.
Yeah.
And Backdraft is a hard two. Which looks like it'll get him some rock. Barrel roll away. Pretty good choice. So Billy's Omega Leader shoots first. Range 2 through the rock. Oh, maybe not. Looks like he's got rock. We're having a discussion.
Looks like they made a call.
Got it. One hit. And he's spending the lock. His Backdraft has no return shot. So now, does he spend the focus? No, he does not. Yay, he gets his damage through.
You see the cheer from Billy.
That's it, he's got half health on Backdraft.
He's a small ship, though.
It's the principle. And here comes Big Bad Vessery. Acquires the lock, spends the lock, spends the focus. Three hits with the tractor beam. And Gilleader just dodges it. Forces him to spend the focus, however. Here come the primaries. And acquires the lock. And spends the lock for two. Come on, magic dice!
Like
the magic
there.
Dice! So it was a stealth device. No. Oh, it was a primary shot. That's why he had four dice.
Yeah, he didn't get the range bonus for the tractor beam, but he did for the primary.
Right. Well, maybe Jeff's Omega Leader shouldn't have gone on a coffee break. Looks like Billy's Omega Leader can just hard three around that rock.
I don't know if chasing down Backdraft is a fun idea, though.
I think it's all he's got.
It is all he's got.
Jeff Spencer, he can bank three. And Omega Leader has to lock one of them this round. You can't have both of them shooting at him modified.
They're waiting for your bet.
Ho! Surprising twist. Switch targets. So a lot of work to do either way. Jeff does a short move. Looks like he's got range. He's gonna focus.
Well, I mean, if Billy can just go one-on-one with the other ships, then it's gonna be the best he can hope for.
Jeff called it.
Yes, he did.
Nice move. And he just barrel rolls that arc. Brutal. Still, that was a very, very nice call for Jeff.
Yeah.
I would have done the bank three. And Jeff, being a good sport, has given Billy a shot on his Omega Leader. Maybe?
It looks so close. It's like right on there.
Billy shakes his head.
Those are the calls that really hurt to make.
Yep. must be Vessery. I think Jeff just switched out his dice. It's four dice now.
Billy very excited about his one of eight.
We got a range three through the rock on a Mega Leader, but this time Backdraft is not locked so he can modify his dice. Spends his focus and acquires crit through Backdraft's ability. And Billy must decide to spend his evade. He does. Lives another round. And fire control system acquires another lock. And the trouble in this situation with for Billy is he's going to have to spend two tokens every round with the amount of guns that get on him.
Yeah.
So it will shed two tokens if there are more than two shots at him. So he can't make any headway in the token game with the Mega Leader.
Yeah, because he doesn't have any way to get extra actions either, so he can only take one token at a time.
And that means no barrel roll to dodge an arc.
Gonna be very predictable in his movements.
Yep.
Yeah, because we won't be seeing sloops either, because that'll just be the death of him.
Yeah. So that was quickly decided. Oh, bank three. He's doing what he can. He's going to try to block a Mega Leader.
Fly away and take his evade.
Yeah. And the block works. And the Omega Leaders have T instead of shooting. This is a hard three. Whoa!
Onto a rock?
A reprieve, a brief reprieve. Looks like he's on it. Yep. Just clipped it.
Yep.
Go! Loses his last shield. Oh no, loses one shield, leaving him one remaining shield.
Alright, looks like the rocks are in Billy's team, so he's got that going for him.
It's so nice when they're on your team. And we have a sloop from Backdraft to come back around.
Is that a sloop? Oh yeah.
He's got pattern analyzer, so he's showing off taking a focus he does not
do. Just because.
No shots here.
Yeah.
So Billy managed to get up a token that round.
Yeah, and everybody's kind of all spread out now, so it looks like he may only have one gun on him in the next round, if any.
Still, it's the most dangerous gun there is.
That's true.
But Messery is locked, so by a megaliter, so he can't modify dice. Do you dare the sloop now with a megaliter if you're Billy?
Maybe. Probably not, because Vessery's just going to come right at him.
But the best Vess can do is a hard three.
True.
And if he throws a barrel roll on at the end of it, which he might as well, because his actions aren't doing anything else for him, he still wouldn't get out of a sloop to megaliter's arc.
Yeah.
So it gives a megaliter one chance to put a crit through.
Yeah, Omegaliter does have to get turned around, so...
Yeah. Billy's going for it.
There it is.
Go, go, Omegaliter. Doing a hard two. His megaliter is very cautious. Very cautious.
Yeah, it doesn't really have to be. It just kind of needs to get some shots in.
Yeah. And just barrel rolls, which means he's giving Vessery room to hard three and barrel roll.
Right. Yep, Vessery's not mad about that position.
And he pointlessly takes a focus.
You're right.
If I were Jeff, I would have done the barrel roll. Even if it doesn't get out of the Megalith's arc, at least he can K-turn the next round. He might be able to K-turn where he is, but... It's funny how much death and destruction a list like Jeff's brings in the first couple rounds of combat, and then how at this point when it's split up, it's just like flailing around.
Yeah, when it's split up, it's not nearly as effective. It can't do fighting to get through a hit. That backdraft is looking ready to start shooting back in.
It's a range two. And here is a megaliter, folks. This is what all hangs on. Oh, my God. Hit crit. That's exactly what he needed.
Let's see.
Oh, man. Nothing. Oh, no. One evade, but it's juked. You can't modify it, so the hit and the crit go through.
Oh, my God.
What's the crit? It's not a direct hit. Didn't he take hit crit?
Oh, he had a shield left.
Oh,
right,
right.
So he took a shield crit.
Right. So Vessery's down to two halt. Ooh, bad evade roll there for a megaliter. What did Vessery roll? Did we see?
This looks like just a, is that a hit or a crit?
All right. Oh, it's a tractor beam effect.
He was determining whether he wanted to spend that token or not.
He's pulling him forward.
Nice juicy primary shot. Is that range one?
I don't think it gives him range one, but it's hard to tell on the screen. Oh, looks like it gave him range one. Oh no, it looks like they're gonna have to
hold the bases.
Oh, it's range two.
I mean, it was worth a shot.
Totally. Plus, it, yeah, I don't know. Just two. Not bad. Oh.
Just blank, though.
Yeah, so I guess he spends the evade and takes the shield. He's deciding.
Yeah, yep. There's no point holding on to that. He needs to live.
Billy's a megaliter, loses his shield. So that didn't in the end go in Billy's favor. One for one, it's not great. Oh no, he got a shield and a crit, I guess.
That's about as good as a Megaliter can do.
Yeah, exactly.
With two red dice.
So yeah, pretty heroic moment for a Megaliter, I take that back. Nice.
Megaliter's gonna pull this out. We got Backdraft down to half. Vestry's only got two.
You putting money on this in?
I'm not gonna put any money on it, but there's still hope.
Yes. Yeah, Billy knows what he's doing immediately. I wonder what the crit... I'm gonna go find out what the crit is on that. Sorry.
Yep.
Oh, stun pilot on this ring. So, it doesn't matter much.
So, Billy's gonna have to do a green maneuver. He's stressed.
I can't see anything there but a hard two. Maybe a three straight will clear it, but tactically, I don't know how great that is.
Hard two.
Stay behind. Billy's a mega leader. They are having a little discussion. He's doing a five straight. Hoping to throw Jeff off with...
Trying to build his token stack.
Well, he's retaining stress, so that's not working.
Why did I think that was green?
Just hoping to...
he's like, okay, maybe I'll just confuse my opponent.
Jeff does not dare the 4K.
Wouldn't have made it. No way.
Barrel roll, perhaps? I mean, it would be worth it for Vessery to take a target lock here. Just even though he can't use it right now, if Billy
just
switches his lock, then it goes to someone else. Oh, looks like Jeff's Omega Leader's finally being called in by the other guys.
He just needed to reposition. Takes time.
So the five straight worked pretty well for Billy.
There we go. Billy's ready for the next round.
Yep. Yeah, it was a good gambit. Some pretty heroic flying for Billy here. And
yeah, for sure.
Against severe odds.
It's nice to see it, though, when somebody, like, they're down by so much and they still try to fight it out to the end. See how much they can do, even maybe pull it out.
Absolutely. This is when you really see a pilot show his quality. Or her quality. As with your heroic K-turn in the last one.
That's how almost all my games end, with a K-turn and a prayer.
We should get that on a t-shirt. K-turn and a prayer. Now Bon Jovi is in my head. So he's playing keep away. He's gonna have to do a green now.
And there's not very many ways for him to go since he's headed toward the board edge.
Yep. Vessery K turn.
Do you think he'll K turn instead of doing like a hard three or something?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, there's. The K turn will get him turned around faster.
Yeah.
And there's absolutely no danger for a defender doing that.
Apparently, it's not an easy decision.
I guess
thinking
not.
Thinking about it.
You're a defender, Jeff. K turn.
He's Ty Devo.
It's true. It's a totally different beast. I think the circumstance, however, is. Still
yeah.
choice.
I mean, he needs to keep the pressure on Billy, but I don't think he needs it that bad.
Oop, Billy's tired. Couldn't figure out if he needed to remove that stress. can't lock anybody but Vess, so
evade time. Yeah, I don't know why I wouldn't just take his evade.
Yep. Only a two bank from Jeff's Megalator.
I'm surprised he didn't just shoot like more forward. Straight.
Yeah, I thought for sure he'd use a three bank, a three straight. He's gonna barrel roll, and then he's nicely lined up for an attack run next round, whatever happens this round. Is Jeff's Megalator locked on Billy's Megalator?
I think it's hard to tell because he only has them down for one half.
I hate that. Confuses the hell out of me.
I think it might be Backdraft's target lock.
Right, in the fire control system. But then Vestry doesn't have one, so must be his. And he's doing a bank, moving out so he can come back in next round. And there you go. Jeff knows stuff about defenders either. I think the overall strategy here is to get the band back together.
Yeah, because Billy's been decently lucky with his incoming attacks and his defense. If there's three people shooting at him, that's not going to hold out.
No. So one damage from Megalator and four evades or something absurd like that from Billy.
He's safe.
Yes.
I'm guessing Omega Leader does have other Omega Leader locked because he didn't juke him.
Oh, he did. It's just that there were three evades on the table, and so it didn't matter. So, X-Wing fans, what do you think? Will Billy be able to take down a ship?
Billy's not facing the right way right now.
No. Looks like hard one or a hard turn is the only choice for him. He's going to have a Megalator coming in from behind. Jeff's a Megalator, that is. And Vestry doing a hard three?
I would say another hard three.
Will he land on that rock if he does that? If that rock takes
He's already risked it before, so. Oh, yeah, that'd be real close.
It's the story of Billy and the rock. He might just bank one and reposition with the barrel roll. After all, he doesn't need actions. Or anything else. Can't use him so long as the Megalator hasn't locked.
Yeah, that's true.
There's the hard one. Right call, I think.
Now, he's got to try to do something to defend himself.
Is he going to barrel roll or focus? He's just going to focus.
I think the token will be more handy than the barrel roll.
Yeah. Zoom. Ooh, that looks like death.
Lots of room.
Sweet. Fits in. Next round, though, Vestry. Next round. Oh, he's just going to barrel roll up. Well, prototype Toronto League fans, this looks like curtains for Billy.
Yeah.
He would need some extra supply of his already famous magic in order to...
Well, it's not over till the dice have gone.
That's true. He's shooting at Vestry.
Vestry could die here.
Vestry could totally die. Come on, Omega Leader.
Oh, it's close. The chicken for Ark,
oh,
I guess.
Oh, for the Ark, yeah.
Yeah, because I thought Vestry had escaped it with that barrel roll.
Yeah, I think so. This might be an aspirational measurement on the part of Billy. Yep. Yep.
Get out the range three. You might have the back corner.
That's like a good a good three pieces of spaghetti in between that ruler.
I like that you use spaghetti as your measurements. Yeah.
Sometimes spaghettini if it's very close.
Angel hair.
Yeah, angel hair. So he's shooting backdraft, I guess? And backdraft events. Why would backdraft get four dice? I don't get it. Oh no, it was Vestry after all. And it was a direct hit? Oh no. Yep, it was a direct hit. But the simultaneous fire.
Right.
So we did get Vestry. And Vestry misses with the ion tractor beam, and then just one. And a megaliter invades. Holy smoke! Well done, Billy, well done.
I mean, honestly, I'm rooting for Omega Leader here. I want to see him do it. I want to see him do it.
You mean good universe Omega Leader. Okay, now it's backdraft laying into him. Oof. He's got a lock. Ooh, it's a bad roll. Target lock. And hit crit.
One,
and
two.
Spends
three
the evade.
Evade. Doesn't have that token anymore, though.
Still got that focus token. And
ooh. Three. That's.
Did he just? Oh. Right, he's juked. Takes a hit. Is it just a hit? I thought
just
it was a crit.
Just a
wow.
Hit.
So against all odds, Billy has survived the round and crushed
Vestry.
Wow. I mean, this is some mighty style points that Billy is earning here.
Yeah, he's certainly not going to go down without a fight.
So, two hull remain on his Omega Leader. Where does he go now?
Hmm.
Time to kill backdraft, right?
Yeah. But if he goes for backdraft, he's going to have just the other Omega Leader right behind him shooting at him.
I think if Billy does two straight with his Omega Leader, anticipating a turn away from backdraft, who always likes to show his rear end.
Right.
They'll be jostin'.
Yeah.
But he's got to grab a lock and an evade token somehow, so maybe he'll try a misdirect for this next turn. Jeff's got pattern analyzer on backdraft. Yep, he attempts the misdirect again. Five straight. Grab a locker a bit. Hope to live.
Taking a lock.
Right. Let's see if Jeff called it this time.
Sloop.
Yep. Safe move.
Yeah, for sure.
And three straight. Uh-oh. Three bank. Uh-oh.
Is he clear? Oh, he clears that.
He clears it. Yikes.
Range one out the back.
But because he's now locked him, he can't add the crit.
Oh, true.
And he cannot use his target lock to reroll dice. So it's just three dice versus three dice. So Billy gets lucky. He takes one or no damage.
We've said that a lot about Billy. Billy gets lucky.
Yeah. I can't believe he got best last round.
Looks like a... Oh.
That was it.